Hello friends, my name is Pradyuman and welcome to my channel VMware NSX Cloud. Here I share step-by-step videos. If you like my content, then do subscribe to my channel and press bell icon for future video notification. So far in this series, we have completed vRealize Lifecycle Manager deployment. Now it's time to start deployment of vRealize Suite Workspace 1, Access and Identity Management software. Without wasting time, let's start installation of Workspace ONE Access. In order to start, we will log into SDDC Manager. Now we will navigate to Management Workload Domain. Here we will select Services tab and then we'll launch the Lifecycle Manager. Let's log in to vrlcm using VCF admin account. You will be presented with My Services screen before we start deployment of WSA. WSA is Workspace ONE Access. We need to create a certificate in Locker. This certificate should have all the names which we are planning to use with WSA deployment. For example, hostname and FQDN. Once certificate generation is complete, it's time we create admin and config admin accounts, which we will be leveraging for the deployments. After creating account passwords, let's click on vRealize Suite Lifecycle Manager icon on the top left. Now select Lifecycle Operations option. Now click on Settings and choose Binaries. Now sync binaries before starting the deployment. After syncing binaries, move to Create Environment option and create a new global environment. By enabling Install Identity Manager radio button, select default password and data center on which WSA will be deployed. Now move next to select the product. Now select the product and deployment type. We have two options, standard and cluster. I will be installing it in standard mode as it's a lab environment. However, in a production environment, we will typically go for a cluster type. Until we have a specific use case or solid reasoning for standard mode deployment. Accept end user agreement and select the certificate we created at the beginning of the video. Choose cluster and resource pool and disk mode. Last option to use content library is useful when you have poor network latency between vrlcm and vCenter. You would find most of the details are pre-filled based on previous configuration in VCF. On products page, you define size of the appliance and VM name of the appliance for vSphere inventory, FQDN and IP of the appliance. Once done, we move on and start the pre-checks and wait for them to pass. As all pre-checks are passed, now we start deployment of Workspace ONE Access appliance. Let the complete workflow finish, it would take some time. Hence, if you want, you can go ahead and get a cup of coffee, sit back and relax. You can also validate appliance deployment in vCenter recent tasks. Now you have a working workspace one access deployment. You can validate the install in workload domain services tab. This is it for this video. I hope I was able to add some value. If you like the content, then please like and subscribe my channel. And if you have any suggestions, please leave it in the comment section. It will help me staying motivated. See you soon with my next video. Thank you for watching.